Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today I will show you how to make your own calculator using LabVIEW. Okay, so this is the front panel and this is the block diagram as you can see. So if you right click here in the block diagram, you can see the structure. So in the structure you have to select case structure. So to how to use case structure that I shown in my earlier videos. So here the default there are two cases, okay. So but if you want to add more function or if you want to use make your calculator, so you have to add more function, not only true and false. So here I am using first one is the 0 and second one is the 1, and I will add more cases if right click here and then add case after, so you can make it 3, and if you right click here and you can get add case after, so you can make it 4. So 0 then 1 then 2, okay, so 2 then 3, okay, so there will be total 4 cases, fine. So now I have to do for 0 case, let's say you want to do some addition, so go to the numeric and then add. So just click here and in the output this is 2 for input, okay. This word is broken because there is no control, so that's why it is showing like this. So you have to go there and create, okay, let's delete it, CTRL B, and here you can create control and then you can make it outside the box. Okay, for Y also create control, then you can put it outside the case structure. Okay, so and here you have to create one indicator so that will act as a display of your calculator. Okay, so now you can name is also like this, instead of numeric you can make it display. Okay, fine. So now for case number 1, so you can this first one is the addition, next one you can go to the then you can use the subtract. So similarly you have to connect with this X and this Y and this output in the display. And for case 3 or case 2, you can go to the numeric and then multiply and then do like this. So you can go here and this X you can connect with X and Y you will connect with this second port. Now for case 3 you can go to the numeric and then choose divide and then you can connect this output in the display and this X and this in the Y. Okay, now everything is okay, but you are not putting any default case, one reason, and second one is the there is no case selector. Okay, so here I will put one case selector. Let's put one case selector in the front panel, go to the ring and then you can choose the menu ring so that you can get the menu, or you can name it like operation or functions. Okay, fine. So here you can see in the drop, this is a drop down menu, and there in the drop down menu there is no option to choose, so you have to go to the right click and then go to the data entry or in the properties. Okay, so in the properties you can say for 0, for case value 0, that means you can go put add and then insert. Then for second you can put subtraction, that means sub, and then for third or okay you can put add multiplication. And for the last one you can put division. Okay, so but as my in my case structure this is in the first case, so you can move it up. Subtraction you can move in the second position and multiplication you can move in the third position. Okay, fine. Now click OK. So you can see there are total 4 options to choose. Okay, then you just connect with this function palette or ring to the case selector, so it will select accordingly this will choose automatically. Okay, so now there is this is not not there is some error is there, so let's make it one default case. Okay, so let's make 0 case is the default case. Okay, so make this default case. So now everything is fine, so you can do all the operation. Like for example here I put x equal to 10 and y equal to 5. Okay, here by default it's choose add. So let's run the program. It will come 15. Okay, it came 15. But if you change this subtraction, then if you run, it should come 5. Let's do that. See, it came 5. So, and if you choose the multiplication, then if you run the program, it will come 50. See, it came 50. So, and if you choose the division, then if you run the program, then it will come 2. 10 divided by 5 equal to 2. Okay, so that's how you can use your to make your own calculator. So if you want, you can make more, you can add more function, like here if you right click here, then you can add case before or after. So then you can add, for example, e to the power x, for example sin x, cos x, tan x, log x, so whatever you want. So accordingly you have to do like this way. So whenever you will choose this function, then you can put the control parameters, and if you run the program in display option, you will get the result. Okay, so that's how you can add more function, and your calculator will have more operations. Okay, so if you have any problem, you can write in the comment box. Okay, so thanks for watching. Let's stop today.